to compete and to gain ascendancy over others. And that is the struggle for existence, for the betterment, which has created the forces required for evolution. This is in fact the only power which has been moving the wheel of evolution. Remove this and the life would come to a standstill at its very earliest stage. Now this was totally misunderstood by Marx, and this is now the only factor, the most important factor I should say, which is going to undo Marxism, and it has already started undoing it. And Marx himself unknowingly admitted this fact in one of his letters written to Engels. You know, he, in his last days, he spent a miserable life in England, in London. One cold winter, he was suffering very much, he required money, and he had to earn his living as a laborer. Now, laborer was the class in the society for whose honor he was fighting, or he had been fighting all his life, according to him. And he said, this is the most honorable part of the society which must gain ascendancy over every other class. But when he went to earn his own living as a laborer, he felt so diminished, he felt so, low in his own eyes. He felt so degraded and insulted that he wrote a very pathetic letter to Engel. And in that letter he says that, today, out of poverty, I had even to stoop to earn my living through labor, hard labor. And then he quotes Bible. Then he is reminded of a verse of the Bible that man cannot live by bread alone. I have realized this now, that even if I were earning bread through labor, there were other factors involved. And just man cannot live by bread alone. That was the undoing of Marxism, which he didn't know. He had even admitted, but he couldn't reach the truth deep enough. Man is a very complex animal. It is not just the equitable distribution of food which he requires. He has many, many desires which create a position of immorality or morality, both. If you read the philosophy of the teachings of Islam, there you will find the very fundamentals of morality, how these qualities can be turned into morality or immorality both ways. But they are the moving force or the basic energy which is required to move life ahead and forward. Now, for instance, I'll explain further. If you have brought a society to a level economically, it would be a very bored man who gets satisfied with that state of affairs. To eat and sleep and do one's job and leave it at that would create such boredom in that society. People would reach for something great, something to establish their supremacy over others. And they will not be able to live without power. And there will be struggle for power, struggle for other things. And in every movement a crime would be born, or many crimes would be born. To reach power is an urge in man. Even if he is full of stomach, that stomach would not deprive him of that urge to rule others. And this is why millions of crimes were born in communist societies everywhere. In Russia itself, in the very first revolution, in the very first days, in the days of those who were, according to the communist tenders were the most honest and trustworthy people in the days of Lenin himself. He had to shoot down thousands of innocent people, and the poor people for that matter, the laborers themselves, to keep his supremacy. In the name of communism, of course, in some name always, but the crime is committed. The unevenness of power is something which you can't do away with. Then there is unevenness of features, of qualities of man. Some people are born beautiful, some with defects. There are jealousies, love and hatred. So many things. So deprive man of one unevenness, his mind and his nature would create so many in place of that one-leveled society or one-leveled feature of the society. And that goes on. This is why a few years ago, when I met a Chinese counselor in Lahore, in connection with some sport, I was also connected with Pakistan basketball, and he was also representative of China in this region. So at a party connected with basketball, we met together. And I pointed out to him that I have noticed in your publications a very strange lack, and that is causing suspicions. I can't have any trust in any of your publications now, because there is everything except the mention of crime. So that means you are artificially feeding the outside world with a heavenly society which is just not there, because it's not natural. I said, I cannot conceive of man without crime. Even in a communist society, there are so many other factors compelling him to crime and to break laws and things. So he promised to write back, and from then on, they started writing on crime in communist world more openly than so. Now, I complimented myself, maybe I was wrong. Maybe they themselves tried to do that, but I think that must have played a role in this. Now, once I started reading about the crime in communist world, then also the news started coming of various other crimes, and they admitted and putting people to death, the rape, the forgery, the stealing and things, while it was a communist society. People were assured of bread and everything. For power struggle, for so many factors, for jealousies. So, how could you bring a society of evil forces which could eliminate immorality? No answer. The result was that Marx himself was conscious of this basic inherent weakness of communist philosophy. And so he created a world of utopia for himself. Why? Mainly because of one thing he was very certain, that after a while the communist world would enter a state of power, struggle for power. And the struggle for power and trampling of individual rights and individual liberty would destroy entire communism and the communist philosophy. Because in the name of individual rights and in the name of individual liberty, you are creating a society which ultimately shackles the entire individuals, entire individualism itself, and leaves everybody bound to a philosophy and a regime, a power, in which individualism plays no role. And whoever comes to power through hook or crook stays there and knows no morality to check himself. So what is the answer? Then he built that utopia which I have referred. He said, ultimate goal for communism is stateless society. When we reach that stage, that would be the heaven on earth. But how stateless society? Because there are other